his name, Ray. Van Richten. This wasn't authored by Van Richten?
Nope, it was not. It was authored by a KN. And I think I know what the K stands for.
What?
Kazan.
She leaves.
Kazan, I believe. Yes. Kazan. Kazan M.
Does that name sound familiar to you, Reginald?
DM, does it?
You don't think so.
Okay. So, there are no elves here?
Esmerelda tells of the last remaining tribe of Dusk Elves that live near Valaki. As far as I know, they are an endangered group of people.
What about other peoples?
Like what?
Dwarves, gnomes, the bald ones, you know, well, of course, besides, you know, Squeaks people, but the flying ones, and I can't think of any others. But Barakakra, that's what I was thinking.
Mm-hmm.
There's none of these people here?
No, I do not believe so, no. I honestly do. I don't have any idea what a dwarf is. Forgive me.
So imagine a man, but much shorter and stout.
Very strong and very stubborn. And very
like
good metal workers.
Ooh, tell me about them.
I can't say I've met very many of them, but I know that a lot of people will seek their help when they want fancy armor or weapons made. At least back in our world. Place. Whatever.
I'm so sorry, you must excuse me. I have nothing to do in here except read and listen to Esmerelda, so I'm easily fascinated by peoples and places of other kinds.
I see. Well, I've never been much of a storyteller, so I don't know what else to tell you.
Storytelling is amazing.
She suddenly feels very much on the spot and is kind of inching away.
Well, I wouldn't want to make you uncomfortable, my dear.
It's fine. Mm-hmm. Sorry, go ahead.
And I suppose I take this cue and I say, would you be willing to lend me that letter there? That piece?
Of the woodland.
The one that he just read.
Oh, yes, yeah. Of course. I mean, I can't really restrain it from you, so.
Still lying. He's like, I couldn't stop you if I wanted to, but sure.
Still, I'd like to know that I'm not doing something out of turn. And I appreciate your go ahead.
I respect your sense of politeness very much. shoot. There was a second volume to that. I just don't know where it is.
Yeah. I'm sure we'd find it if we clean up. If we just clean up around here. Sure, we'd find it soon enough.
I'll continue to pick up around and dust off stuff and kind of mutter under my breath when I puff up some dust or whatever. Don't you have some sort of spell that just cleans everything?
I'm sorry.
That was directed at Reginald, sorry.
Okay. Sorry, I should
shut up now. Oh, I see. Very well. I cast Prestidigitation to clean the room.
Ooh.
Fancy. A lot of the papers assort themselves into books that they originally were part of, and some wood reassembles itself, and dust disperses into the air, and down the well. Or not well, elevator.
He whistles whistle while you work.
Honestly, I was thinking that too.
Reginald, give me a perception check.
Aye, very well. Oof, that was almost good. 10.
I'll say this anyway. You see some papers around Buster assemble themselves into books on the shelf. One closer to you on the right, and one closer to Lottie on the left.
Oh, I grab that one. I'll check this one.
Alright, I'll grab the one by me. Yoink. I'm going to have to learn that spell. It seems very handy.
When I used it to defend myself from the horde of vampire spawn sent by Strahd to harm me. I used it to protect myself, and it burned the flesh of the undead to ash. I have never been in awe of such power before. I took the symbol back to the faint defender friends, and told them of the tale that had just happened, and they had taken me to the shrine of the Forest Fae. I presented the holy encrusted gem to the lady, and uttered a prayer to the lady by name. After that, the most astounding thing happened. Ravens now heeded my call. Feathers as black as midnight, and eyes as bright as the moon. A kind of magic that I was in awe of. I knew of my purpose was to serve this once great Fae and her last remaining defenders. I had sold a great deal of my wares to the Burgomaster of Kresk, to purchase a winery he owned beneath Kresk. So long
when
as
she reads that, she'll be like, oh! I'm sorry. Go ahead.
So long as I continue the trade, I could own the winery, as well as my very descendants. I would use this plot of land to set up a base for the Feint defenders. Together with the glory of the Seeker and her people, I would defend Barovia from the nefarious Kafani and Strahd. Whether by magic and sword, or beak and talons, I would be what Barovia needed.
Mm. Lottie is depressed now. Alright, what was the description of the item he received? Something, it was ruby encrusted, or?
You read back some sentences and you see a beautiful encryption of the sun with a glowing red gem inside.
And that's the raven thing?
So
or no?
The book says.
Okay. She'll close the book. Mind if I hang on to this for a moment?
I'm sure I would not offend anyone.
Thank you. Find anything interesting over there, Reginald?
I'd be looking through the cosmology book and try and find my page.
Once again, do you want to read it yourself out loud, or do you want me to read it to you?
Could you read it?
Sure. Barovia's cosmology. Before beginning, I'd like to stress the intent behind the book's title. Barovia's cosmology, rather than Barovian cosmology. Barovian cosmology suggests the ideas and studies the Barovian people themselves have made and deduced by viewing and analyzing their own sky. That, however, is impossible in Barovia. The title is called Barovia's cosmology because it suggests the land itself is part of a grander cosmos. Or perhaps, as I'll dive into later, is actually cut off from the rest of the greater cosmos. As I'm sure it might be evident to anyone else who is an outsider to these lands, Barovia is quite unusual in comparison to the material plane. That is because it is meant to be an uncanny reflection to the material plane, as well as many more. For you see, Barovia, for reason likely thanks to Strahd von Zarevich himself, has been assimilated as part of the Shadowfell. A plane of raw negativity, darkness, and corruption. It is a perversion of everything an ordinary person might see as normal or good. That is why no sun exists within Barovia, because the concept of one only exists in the minds of its inhabitants as a means of torturing them, to provide them a vague sense of what they are missing out on, the warmth, holy light, and natural sustenance humans, and perhaps other humanoids, gain from sunlight, is meant to not be here, and is meant to instill as much pain and suffering as possible. You may not readily understand how much you might miss the sun until its nightfall lasts a full day, or week, or year. An important distinction to be made when comprehending the Shadowfell is that it is a reflection of many different worlds, not just the ones you, dear reader, might have originally inhabited or imagined before. It is a gateway plane that can be used to transverse the multiverse, should one be skilled enough to do so. Perhaps that is why I ended up here myself. In my hubris, I believed I could manipulate the shadows themselves to take me to different places I wanted to see. Planes I believed could be real, but could never be certain. But I suppose I wasn't skilled enough. Or perhaps I have transgressed some natural order to the wider weave, the wider ebb and flow of things, so to speak. the mists themselves, sometimes also called shadow mists, are indistinguishable from normal mist to the untrained eye. But upon further inspection, one can see that it moves and acts of its own accord, as if with a specific intent and motive behind its slow, methodical movements. It leads me to believe there is an intelligence behind the mist, or perhaps within it. It is possible that some kind of god, or gods, could have created the Shadowfell, and Barovia as a whole, to contain Strahd's immense capacity for destruction. Perhaps this is true. However, a counterpoint to this theory is that why would a good god wish to imprison a vampire with an appetite like Strahd's, with so many innocent people, if the gods simply wish to punish him alone? Another idea is that the gods themselves are evil, and have created Strahd themselves to be an avatar for their own nefarious desires. However, the question to that then becomes, why can't Strahd leave? He has never been shown to return from anywhere else, nor does he express any first-hand knowledge from different planes. I grow curiouser by the day. Unfortunately, as far as I know, there is no way to escape Barovia. Not as long as Strahd disallows it. But it's not impossible to view other planes. I've developed a scrying telescope that allows me to see my home again, as long as I speak my name Kazan to it. However, when I try to see something through it, I'll gain a peek at first. But it's as if the moon itself is trying to block my view. Authored KM.
I think I know who this KM is. Reginald. I think he is the former Wizard of Wines.
I see. So he was just as much of a poor, unwilling passenger as we were.
Yes. But now we have depression.
Seems now as though the only way for us to even hope to escape is to kill Strahd. Jesus, I'm becoming Sir Alec Guinness. Jesus. It seems now.
Sorry, go ahead.
Seems the only way we could possibly escape is to either force Strahd to move us, or do him in.
Can he move us if he wanted to?
It says here that no one may leave as long as Strahd disallows it.
That does sort of imply that somebody has been. Oh, I think I know somebody who was.
Yeah.
Our host at the very first party.
You're right! Lottie, you're a genius! I say, just grabbing you and throwing you around.
Not really. He's clearly allowed on the to leave.
Well, yes, but you only brought up because a very good point.
Okay. He's a little worried. I'm saying he probably only allows people to leave who work for him, and I don't think any of us want to do that.
No, but that power exists. And as long as that power exists, we still have yet some shred of hope.
I suppose. But how do we claim mastery over it? Except to, you know, like you were also suggesting, this vampire lord who seems to be all-powerful. My guns can kill a lot of things, but I haven't ever aspired to kill a demigod, and I'm not sure I'm ready to start now.
I hold up Van Richten's guide. If one man figured it out once, it can happen again.
But he didn't. Strahd lives. He's not just a regular vampire, is he? Or do all vampires wield control over entire realms like this? I can't say I've encountered many. I've only heard stories. And half of them, I'm pretty sure, were fiction.
Still, there's some part in me, some irrational, yet glimmering part inside of me that just barely dares to hope. The only way we'll find it.
Sorry, go ahead.
The only way we could ever even become close to getting out of here, or even to figure out Strahd, is to move forward.
Amen. Perhaps your optimism would be enough to carry the both of us. Because I can't imagine not returning home. And yet I can't imagine a way to do it. It's a very uncomfortable sort of place to be in the mind, I suppose. But if you believe there is a way, I will chance to hope.
Then we haven't a moment to lose.
Shall we rejoin the others?
I suppose we shall.
Alright.
Thank you, sir. It's been a pleasure meeting you.
I hope you are well. Feel better.
As I hope the best of luck to the lot of you as well.
Okay. Do you need any other pages turned before we leave?
Honestly, it seems like you may need more knowledge than I. I'd be happy to provide anything I do know, but unfortunately my memory can be unreliable at times.
I know, but I feel terrible that you are laid up in here without anything to do.
Well, Esmerelda is a terrific companion, and I shan't think of the thought of her line of work ever claiming her.
Yes, it is better not to worry about those things.
Pass me any random old book, and I'll consider that more than a handful of favors.
Alright, she'll go pick one randomly off the shelf that looks like it has a pretty cover, and put it on the floor.
Alright, you see one that is very beautiful looking, and you simply put it at the base of Buster's statue, and yeah. Thank you, my dear.
Pleasure talking to you, Buster. And she'll
likewise.
Head over to the carpet. She'll give a quick bow.
The carpet is currently ascended.
Ah. Is there any way to call it down?
Could you send the carpet back down? We'd like to have a little chit-chat.
You could just try calling for Esmerelda. I don't think she went very high.
That's what I was doing. But, Esmerelda! How do you get this confounded contraption to work?
Esmerelda says, and I suppose we'll be going up until she hears you. Oh, okay, I suppose they're done there. Everyone willing to pick them up?
I don't see why not.
Yeah, of course.
Alright. So Lottie and Reginald, you see a smashed level of things with some lights and some forms of technology. Do you say anything before ascending?
I guess I will try to catch them up on some of the, I don't want to have the same conversation over again,
right.
I'll try to catch them up on some of the stuff we read as we're ascending.
Exposition no jutsu.
Yes, exposition no jutsu, exactly.
They all nod their head and be like, yeah.
I understand.
Did y'all have questions?
No.
Okay.
I'm good.
Okay. As the tower elevator ascends, you all are now within Esmerelda's chambers.
Okay.
Home sweet home.
Very nice.
Yes. And there isn't much to advertise here. Just, this is where I sleep, this is where I keep most of my valued treasures, and this is where I plan my next moves, should I ever actually come to the tower.
Well, what exactly have you been planning?
I'm actually sort of glad you asked. So, before I actually made this my permanent home, I went to looking for Van Richten to apologize for just how badly our last meeting ended up. But I noticed he was gone, and then he left me this brief letter. Sorry, and I am trying to go to it. So it reads as follows. Dear Esmerelda, I understand you and I may not have always been on the best terms. I understand that it is partially my fault. However, I feel remorseful for the things I may have said. I do not fully regret the intent behind them. I need you to stay away from me. The ones with that godforsaken temple have damned me. The monsters we hunt, that I hunt, only bring about ruin to those that try to walk. So I'm sorry, but I cannot allow you to accompany me. Do what you can for the people of Barovia. I have trained you well, and my tower will serve you should you ever need it. I will cover my tracks and ensure no one can find me as I locate the three items of power. The three objects I believe are critical to Strahd's downfall. I can travel far and wide, unlike yourself, but unlike your family. I can travel between realms, and I will make sure I locate what is needed to kill that Dark Lord son of a bitch. I understand why you would feel that this is your fight too, truly, but I can't let you fight it. Let me do it for you. That's the last good thing I wish to do in my lifetime of sin. Forget me, Esmerelda. I never forget what I've taught you. sincerely yours, Rudolph Van Richten.
Oh, that reminds me, and I'll, assuming, I don't know who's holding the book, but the anatomy book for vampires. I don't know if Reginald has it or if I do, but I'll just be
I think you left it on the second floor.
I thought I picked it up.
I don't know. We'll hand it.
Okay, I'll hand that to her, I guess. And I'll pull out my book. When we were in the Wizard of Wands home, did we see anything like this? And is there like a picture of the sun thing with the gem on it?
No, there isn't one in the book, but if you described it.
Alright. Some kind of talisman with a sun and a gem in the center. I think it might be important, but I don't know. It was in this book, and he talked about it being from some forest people or something. That was me addressing the party, and I guess they all just stare at me in awkward silence and say no.
Squeaks will poke at you.
Okay, sorry. What is it, Squeaks?
She will rummage into her pocket, and she will pull out a locket that she had found in the Wizard of Wine's home. And on it, there's a crest.
Is it similar to the one that Lottie described, I assume?
Yes.
I believe so, yes.
Could this be the item in question? One of you magic users, come over here and check it out. Have we looked at this? Has anyone else seen this, Squeaks?
She shakes her head.
Reginald, let's take a look, yes.
Aye, the both of us at once.
We go over and look.
Is it magic? Is this thing some item of power, or merely a duplicate? Sorry,
go ahead. I would like to cast Identify, which will take a minute. Identify. I just sent you the semantics of what it does.
Okay. So, you know instantly what this is foretelling. You know that this amulet itself is not magical, but you have a strong, strong, strong sense that the item it's depicting is.
Oh.
So it's like it's a replica.
Is it possible that it was at the Wizard of Wine's house and we overlooked it? Maybe that is what the man who killed the Wizard of Wines was looking for.
Perhaps. But I don't recall anything like that there, at least.
That is distressing. I thought I was onto something.
Well, there's no reason we can't go back and check it out, right?
That is true. Though I wonder if... Well, you're right. We could go back and check it out if we needed to, but I don't even know the significance of the item beyond it was a gift from some forest people who followed some goddesses that opposed Strahd.
We happen to have met a very curious forest person at least once before.
Plus, having someone on our side who is also against the person we are, it wouldn't necessarily be a bad idea to have another ally.
Esmeralda's head picks up. What exactly are you talking about?
What are you suggesting, Vincent? I'm sorry. I don't follow.
I think I have a suspicion. But please elaborate.
Allies. Allies with a common cause.
No, not that. Show me the amulet.
I shall.
Okay.
Weeks will hold it out.
Thank you, dear.
You know about it.
Alright. In... Yes. In the letter, Van Richten has told me that he was locating items of power. I have been hunting that bastard for who knows how long now, and he deliberately left out what he was looking for so that I could have a hard time in finding him. But that... She clicks her tongue. That... Motherfucker, he confuses me for a slow person. Sorry.
Kind of unnerving me with this random laughter.
What
is the joke?
What is
happening?
No joke, I'm just excited. My apologies.
No, it's fine.
So, I believe I know the three items of power that he was foretelling. Now, I know from my own knowledge of Barovian lore of this symbol, and I know that it does have connection to the Martikovs, the winery owners. I know of a sword. I've been looking for a sword for a long, long, long time. But try finding a particular sword in all of Barovia, that's hard. I know it could have been... Let me tell you something. Part of the reason I wanted to see the abbot is because I thought maybe he would know of the sword or have it.
Well, that went poorly.
Yes, that went about as well as... Well, not at all.
No, yes, it went very poorly. Sorry. I suppose I'm rubbing salt in a wound there. Continue.
As for the third, I believe it's a book. As for the third item, I believe it's a book of some kind, but I don't know who wrote it or what it's about. But I know once I find Van Richten, he will spill his guts because I will force him to.
Assuming he hasn't spilled his guts somewhere else. Sorry, inside thoughts. Vincent, you're rubbing off on me.
Squawk.
I'm sorry. Oh, Squeaks is trying to talk. What is it, Squeaks?
Squeaks actually pulls out the handle of the sword that she found by the habit.
Oh, shit!
Holy fuck!
weeks. The Kellen, finder of things.
But holy shit.
Oh, he's covering Callan's ears.
Does he cover his ears?
Not at all, no.
Kieran's covering his ears! Oh, Lord, no!
Not in front of the child!
Just waving around the amulet and the hilt of the sword, like, eh?
Squeaks, you beautiful belt. It seems like you have found something important.
Oh, she most certainly did.
She fluffs up happily. She's a good bird. Good, good bird.
Oh, yeah. What was this?
Abbott.
He had it on him, didn't he?
Nods.
Amazing. Well, good thing we killed him then. Oh, but this is so wonderful.
It only cost everyone their lives. Okay, so this hilt is important?
Yes, or Van Richten thinks so. Yes.
What good is a sword without a blade?
A very good point, Vincent. I was thinking the same thing, but was trying not to say it.
Was that another inside thought?
Not this case, probably. But it's an important point.
Okay. So, while you are right in the analysis that this sword is not in its best shape, I believe I know where to take it.
All right.
Weeks so. Taps at the hilt, though. She taps. Not empty.
Oh?
Full. Because she remembers trying to possess the sword and she couldn't because it felt too full.
Oh.
I'm pretty sure Body has no idea what she means.
Nope. Because you weren't there.
No.
Yeah, I just side-eye Lottie, like.
I'm not very good at speaking squeaks yet.
Full inside.
What?
Not empty.
Full of what?
She's trying to figure out how to say it.
Going through her library of words.
Exactly.
I believe in you, Squeaks. Do it.
Essence.
Essence? Like a smell?
I think more like spirit.
It's possessed?
Tried to possess. Didn't work.
You can possess things?
You can what?
I died. Possess.
Wait, didn't work. This is some information you have not shared.
It's between minor, the really.
Can you provide some insights into what she is saying?
When we were deceased, we needed a vessel of sorts, and we chose a few bodies, and apparently...
You were ghosts?
Well, yes, we were dead.
You were dead and you came back to life.
I was a book for a little bit.
And you're not undead or spirits right now.
Yeah.
Where did your bodies come from? Did you just go? I just assumed you went back in your bodies and dug your way out of the graves. That isn't what happened.
No, not at all, really.
Jumped out.
What?
Jumped out.
jump down?
I don't think our bodies jumped out.
Left possessed.
Perhaps... It's complicated either way. But we have our bodies now, we are alive and well, and isn't that really what matters?
Once again, she is tapping the hilt of the sword. She's getting frustrated.
Yes, so there's something or someone already in there, so you were not able to possess it, yes.
She nods.
You... okay. Lottie's trying to wrap her mind around this, and is just standing there, gesturing in the corner, starting to ask a question, and then stopping, and then thinking a second.
This is a special one.
Yeah, I thought so too, but apparently I didn't know how much.
Would you mind if I casted a spell on it? Have we tried casting Identify on it?
No.
Okay. Would you allow me to cast a spell on it? Get some more information.
And welcome to another use of the Identify spell.
Aye, very well. Another Identify. Another minute goes by.
A minute of tension as you all try to think on what this sword could possibly be. What it could mean. Reginald, you see a depiction of a very, very bright light, all-encompassing, and it emanates into you, through you, for you, and you feel like you see something. You think you see a face, and the face looks very similar to Strahd's.
I communicate everything I see to the party.
So, what is it?
You see Strahd's face?
It certainly looks like it. Are there any, like, clear dissimilarities?
You know Strahd to have very short hair. But this looks like a nearly identical man. Not exact, but nearly. But with longer hair.
The Vistani say something about Strahd having a brother or something?
Well, if they did, they kept that information from me. But anything's possible with that. With that one.
But it was all part of their tale that I'm pretty sure was mostly a lie, saying, oh, his brother's evil and all that.
Perhaps they told a version of the truth.
I wish I could remember more. Do you remember them talking about it at the party?
I have some recollection of it, yes. Though, admittedly, not as
accurately reported as I hoped.
Likewise, unfortunately. I will have to think about it. Or look at my notes. But it looks like I didn't write anything down about that, so fuck me.
Well, this is still excellent news. So, we have one of the fabled items that Richton tells. Just, it's broken. And we at least know what the other looks like. And we do have friends, or I think they'll like us. She's pacing back and forth as she says this. I believe the Mardukovs in the Velaki Inn will at least not hate us.
Well, we were at one point planning to go to that inn to deliver news to the son of his Falzale's passing. A really cheerful and fun trip ahead of us. So I suppose we should head there next.
Yes, and actually, I have a... not a favor, but a recommendation. So, I know you have absolutely no reason to like or trust the Vistani in any way, and I do not blame you. But there is a person there, a woman named Madame Ava, who is a very gifted seer. And as far as I know, she's not evil, but I've met her personally, and she is very gifted. So if anyone knows on what the final object is or how to restore this, or where that thing is, pointing at the symbol, it would be her as well. I just wanted to give you another option, and in case Van Richten is ever wrong, then, or lies, because he would, Madame Ava would not.
Alright.
I'm just saying. I'm just throwing it out there.
What do the rest of you think? I'm a little overwhelmed, frankly.
There's definitely a lot to try to analyze here, but it'll just take time to think on it. Yes.
It has been a full day, so perhaps we should rest.
That's awesome.
I couldn't agree more.
Appreciate that.
In fact, I would also like rest, because I just got strangled by a sack of skin not only 3 hours ago. Two or three.
Sounds like a fun night. Sorry. I feel like I need to get angry at you, Vincent, every time I say something inappropriate.
Well, I didn't even mention anything about the foreskins we had to fight.
I'm sorry, what?
Foreskins.
Is that what you meant?
Sorry
about my wheeze.
Does he have a bandage you can just put over his mouth, or?
Oh no, we left that back at the house.
Ah, yeah. Silly me.
Sorry. That was good. That was really good. Javi made a pun by accident, and Katya was like, here we go.
Let me tuck that one in my back pocket for later.
You should have just had us fight three skins now.
I tried to save you. No, you fought three more. Oh.
Attack so I received four skins.
Thank you.
Yes, you are a genius, and clap, and you get a point of inspiration.
Thank you.
Okay. I can't remember what I was saying before, so y'all
we're resting.
Yes, alright. So I am good to call the session here, but I would like to point two final things. One to Squeaks and one to Vincent.
Uh-huh.
Okay. So we'll go with Vincent first. And you, Vincent, looking over here, you see a large plate of armor.
Okay, I look at the plate of armor.
It has very impressive and intricate design. And right by the foot of it, you notice a small booklet.
Clumsy little booklet down here. I grab it and I read.
Okay. It is very short and a bit hastily written. But you read the words, Artificer's Talent.
That's me. I read more.
Okay. You open the pages. To create is a privilege. I shan't forget that. When Strahd von Zarevich, the horned devil of Zareven, came to none but I for guidance on craftsmanship, I took it as a responsibility to prove myself. A chance to hone my craft and become better, smarter. To weave a new legacy in the art of hammers and metals. I wanted to make his armies things they couldn't believe with their eyes. My magics that wove different components together, like how a pair of scissors binds two different blades effortlessly. Crafting swords with the abilities to shoot bullets, and armors that can cast spells on their own. Wizard tomes written onto the metals themselves in mystic runes. Blades unshackling from blunt objects, and so much more. It really is glorious. I can be what the world needs, and I can start with the Devil of Zareven. However, I feel it necessary to inscribe the things I know. My ideas, my crafts, my need, my profession, and obsession. In case I need to know how to do something again, or combine something I hadn't thought of. So much more. Making weapons into other weapons, armors into magical artifacts, the bodies of powerful magical creatures into either or. I am truly a visionary. With that, I shall get to the work on my true magnum opus, this book. Titled Exathanter.
I put it in my pocket.
It is a small booklet, and skimming through the rest of the pages, it is out of character. It is essentially just a list of things you can do as an artificer within Barovia. So creating trick weapons and ideas for us, you and I, to make lootable items with. So in time, maybe within the week or something, we can look over the rules for artificer and making stuff, and that's what the book essentially tells.
Sure.
So yeah, it is an in and out of character thing, this book.
Sounds good.
Now, Squeaks.
Squeak.
There are a set of windows across this tower. And give me a perception check.
Oh, hey. I got a 4.
Well, shit. So it is very misty outside, and the fumes of the river kind of fog the glass, but through it you see the silhouette of a raven.
immediately go over.
You go over to where this raven is, more to the left of you. And you knock on the window, trying to get the thing's attention. Yes?
Mm-hmm.
It knocks back with its beak.
Is there a way to open the window?
Perception check.
Oh boy. I got a 7.
It doesn't seem like there is a way to open this window, but you think you can clear it with just rubbing your hand on it a bit.
Alright, ugly bird arm, go.
You rub it, and the raven tries to get as close as possible. Like it's trying to analyze you, too.
I press my face against the glass.
It does the same to you.
Ah! I caw back.
You see that this raven is unusually large. Not terribly so, but bigger than an ordinary raven, definitely. And you notice something a little weird about it.
What do I see?
The tips of its feathers are dyed blue.
Alright, I want to go outside.
And we will next session.
Alright.
Alright, beautiful.
Do-do-do-do.
Curse of Strahd. Isn't it beautiful?
Mm-hmm.
We had combat. We had a lot of books that I hope weren't boring.
They were not.
Good.
Very interesting. A lore dump session a little bit.
A tiny bit, yes. I admit it. But nothing wrong with that. It'll be important for later.
Mm-hmm. I tried to pick up what you were putting down.
All right, cool. So, yeah, we had an encounter with some skin creatures. Some
foreskins.
Foreskins, yes. It's funny. Katya, remember your inspiration, because I sure will.
No, I have them marked on my sheet. Don't you worry. And I ask, will you post those book things in Grimoire?
Yes, I will. Yeah, so you guys don't really need to worry if you do forget. Just it's gonna be a lengthy channel.
My head do be empty.
I know.
But yeah, that was fun.
All right. So yes, that was session 8 titled Lighthouse.
Lighthouse.
Hope you like Esmerelda's Tower, because you're going to be resting in it for a bit, and then we're going to go to where we go to, because Valaki is the next place I have the most prepped, as well as the camp next to it, but technically, you guys can go anywhere you want.
So, I think it would be fair to say that we should decide this now, where we're going to go, so you can prep for it.
Okay, that'd be beautiful.
So
what you guys
do we want to go into Valaki, or did we want to double back and check the Wizard of Wine's place? I think, where was it we were going to go to help the little boy?
He mentioned a Valaki orphanage.
Oh, okay. So everything's kind of pointing towards Valaki. Yeah. Everything's pointing towards Valaki except checking out the Wizard of Wine's place again to see if we can find some more clues. But his son is in Valaki, so
yes.
But the crows were also all over the house. So, I mean, but I feel like that still could mean something.
Sure it does.
How far is each destination?
By walk, maybe like 4 or 5 days walking.
No.
To the
No. like from, I mean, from Wizard of Wines to Valaki separate, like it's like under a week of walking.
Okay, so we, because we are on a bit of a ticking clock in terms of werewolf boy.
Yes, and also Valaki from this tower is only a few hours away.
Okay.
By carriage, maybe a little longer by foot. But Esmerelda would want to take you by carriage.
I feel like we should just go to Valaki.
Good.
There's more going on in Valaki.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, we're closest to Valaki. And there's more stuff that... There's more reasons to be there right now than going to the Wizard of Wines just yet.
Just okay. To maybe find something.
Unless Loxy... I want to call you Reginald. I know that's not your name.
The
My
Loxy.
Brain died. The Loxy.
Kieran. Here's the thing. Look, I need to get adoption papers for my future son here. So, like, we're going.
Aww.
We're going to Milwaukee. I'm adopting a kid, and I'm taking him along on this horror journey with us.
That sounds like a way to incur additional emotional damage.
Because, goddammit, yeah. Kieran needs a son.
Uh-oh, you're gonna make Quint... Oh, that sounded kind of bad. You're gonna make Vincent quirky if there's a child traveling with us, because if he dies, I'm gonna lose my mind.
You're gonna hit
oh no.
Oh, that's right.
You already have?
That's right. We, I know, but Charlotte doesn't know, I guess, that you had a son in your backstory. Oh no. You killed him.
Yeah.
Well.
Baby.
It was a baby.
But yeah, Vlocky sounds like a good plan overall.
Yeah. All right.
Can always double back to the Wizard of Wines.
Yep.
Yeah.
We screwed over that one dude who was trying to find the thingy there.
Yeah. Hopefully his friends haven't gotten it.
Yeah. That'd be a real shame.
Mm-hmm.
That'd be a real damn shame.
Real about damn shame we had to invade their like village or whatever and kill them all.
Yeah, that would
be a shame there, bud. Real damn shame. I have to invade your village now.
Yeah,
and not just the men, but the women. And the children
shut the fuck
too.
Up.
No.
Shut up.
Damn it.
Shut up.
You
shut her face.
Turn it to damn Anakin. Oh no.
Yeah, really real Oscar winning dialogue right there. They're like animals. And I slaughtered them like animals. I hate them.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. So, any questions or comments about Kerstrahd before we leave it for 2 weeks?
No, it's bedtime.
Mm. Yep.
Bedtime.
Bedtime.
Bedtime. Bedtime. Bedtime, bedtime. I don't know what I'm singing.
Oh, that pisses me off. I think at some point my footage cut, and I'm gonna have to put two videos up of the same session. That's annoying.
Yeah, baby, double feature.
Double ads.
I don't get ads. I don't get fucking ads. Too small.
Okay, you're an average size streamer.
Yeah. You're a grower, just not a shower.
Thank you.
Which
long pause.
Guys, don't make me laugh. It hurts.
I'm sorry.
Oh, I'm sorry. It only hurts when I breathe.
No, you need a cough to get that shit out.
It hurts.
Yeah, we're just expectorants. Don't worry about it.
Mm-hmm. Good game, guys.
Yeah.
Good job.
GG.
Alright. Well, bye.
Later.
This tournament 2 weeks.
Yeah. I put an event.
That's like, for me, that's like 8 years, guys.
Hobby.
Stroking.
Ooh.
What happened?
That's what I named it. Curse of stroking.
Oh. Ouch.
Or I guess it should be this too.
Hydrate, kitty. Hydrate. Javi lives in dog shit.
Ew.
Hold on, let me click on it. Let me click on it and mark that I'm interested.
You're interested in...
I'm interested.
Yes, she's interested in the foreskin. Enjoy your point of inspiration.